So good morning students, today we will do revision of the poem The Road Not Taken. The Road Not Taken, written by Robert Frost. Before that, bachcha, I want to share one thing with you. Today there will be a listening task. This listening task is a part of your internal assessment. Okay, so I will be sharing one of the listening tasks with you. For that, what you have to do, listen all the guidelines carefully and keep all of you, keep yourself mute. Okay, so what you have to do, I will be sharing one of the tasks with you. You have to listen to that video, audio video. See the expressions of your face. Don't be so tense. You will enjoy this activity. And this activity will give you marks for your internal assessment. So what you will do, you will listen that video. That is APJ Abdul Kalam, one of the speech that I'm going to share with you. After listening to that speech, you will open Google form. I will be sharing you one of the link. Okay. So in that, all the question answers of listening task, they will be given in the MCQ form. Okay. So if you have listened that video very, very carefully, you will be able to do that listening task. Okay. Then what will you do? After doing that listening task, you will take a screenshot and you will send in English group only. Not send to me individually, send in English group. And one thing more, last week when test was conducted, there are so many smart students, they take the test from other phones. When they score good marks, then they take a screenshot and they send to me. But when they score less marks, they don't take screenshot and they don't send to me. And bachche, this app is very powerful app, Google Form. Your name, everything is visible here. If one of the students has done that test 2, 2, 3, 3 times, it is also visible. And I will cancel that test this time. Last time I have taken the marks because if you have conducted 3 times the test and the marks that I have taken the lowest marks. There were 2 students of my class who were fail in that test. It is so surprising. This test was so simple. But 2 students were failed and they did not send me the screenshot. But I have seen their performance. Because technology is so fast. If you are smart, the technology is over smart.
When the name is written from one student to 2, 3 tests, you get to know that this student has done. But when some students do with a fake ID.
Na, this fake ID is also visible. IP address can be found. From which device they are doing this? From which number? It is also easily reachable. So don't be over smart. Listen that video. Sit alone in separate room. Okay. You can have headphone. Otherwise, you can keep the room closed. Listen that video very, very carefully. Keep pen or pencil with you. Okay, you can jot down main details of that speech, main points, keywords. Then you start doing that listening task straight away afterwards. Okay, so today it will be sent to you. At what timings, what the format of that test, all the details will be sent in English facility. Sorry, English 9th A English group. Okay, so you have to go according to that. And if you are not able to submit the test on time, then no marks will be given to you for internal assessment. And afterwards, don't run after me that I was not able to take the test. There was a problem like that, blah, blah, blah. Yes. No, that is up to you. Video I have sent you. You can listen that video 2 times also. But there will be a time limit. Okay, the time limit will be sent to you. During that time limit, you are supposed to send me the test. Clear?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
मैम, इन द टर्म वन द इन इन ग्रामर देयर आर मेनी टॉपिक्स रिटन, सो हमें सिर्फ वही आएंगे एडिटिंग और ओमिशन और गैप फिलिंग.
वट एवर द टॉपिक्स विच आर गिवन टू यू, एरर फाइंडिंग रिलेटेड टू दैट, एरर फाइंडिंग, एरर ओमिशन, गैप फिलिंग, रीअरेंज, ऑल दीज विल बी आस्क्ड. ओके, बिकॉज अप टू 8th फॉर्मेट इज डिफरेंट, बट इन 9th फॉर्मेट इज कम्प्लीटली चेंज्ड. Up to 8th, one sentence was given and you were supposed to solve that sentence. But in 9th, error finding, error omission, gap filling, in the fill-up form, this grammar will be asked. Clear? So let's start revision of the poem, The Road Not Taken. And all of you be attentive. See, Road Not Taken. This is a very beautiful poem written by Robert Frost. Okay, so Robert Frost is telling in this poem that here the speaker, he is the Robert Frost, he is the speaker of the poem. He is, you can say, in confusion. Why so? Because there is option in front of him. He has to choose one option because he is standing on a place where in front of him two roads are diverged in two sides, left and right. But it is very much hard and complicated decision to be taken, that what choice he has to make, either to go there or to go here, because two of the roads are equally, you can say, equal for him. He is not able to make a decision. Why two roads are appealing equal to him? Because two roads are both promising. But it was a very hard decision, and this poem is full of moral, because in our life also it happens with us that we have to take one decision and it becomes very much complicated for all of us to make that decision. But one of the decision can make our life, or it can also mar our life, it can spoil our life. So whole of the life is dependent on your decision. Okay, what happens when two options are given to you? People choose which option? Suppose I give you any kind of assignment or I give you any kind of task, okay? There will be some students who will spend so many hours on that activity, okay? And they will say, no, I want to give my best. So those who want to reach at the highest point, those who want to excel in their life, those who really want to get success in their life, what will they do? They will apply shortcut? No. They will not apply shortcut. They will go in detail. They will do research on that. They will study for that. They will not think only about that, I have to finish this work. They will give their 100% in that work. And after that, what will be the result? They will be passed with flying colors. But there are some students also who want to gain success using shortcuts. Which kind of shortcuts? That they don't want to do hard work. They don't want to give plenty of time to that work. Okay, so what will be the result? What will be the result? Do you think they will be succeeded in their life? They will get success in their life, those who want to go for the shortcuts? No. So this is basic the moral of the poem, The Road Not Taken. Simran, I just take your doubt. So The Road Not Taken is basically a making about a choice, that you have to make a choice. Okay, Simran, what do you want to ask?
Ma'am, apart from this poem, sometimes making shortcuts, don't you think that sometimes hard work doesn't pay off? I mean, it does, but smart work is much more effective, and sometimes smart work is more appreciable. In smart work, like, we don't work hard, but the project which is given is same, the method is same, but just a little bit less of the time given to the project, but still the outcome is more effective than the hard work. In today's time, creativity is like appreciated more.
Yes, I am 100% agree with you. For smart work is there, but this poem is giving a message for which kind of person. See, I'm not against smart work. Smart work can be there. So smart work can be there, but it doesn't mean that every time if you do only smart work, you don't want to put efforts. Okay, now the generation is changing. They are in the favor of that. They should do smart work instead of doing hard work. But don't you think that by only and only doing smart work, you will be able to get success? Okay, smart work, I agree. Sometime it is really effective, because sometime we can have a short time and we think that this shortcut can be applied to get success. Okay, but if you do, suppose any of the child, he wants to get first position. Okay, online exams are going on. So he wants to excel, he wants to gain more than 95%. So he is burning midnight oil. He is working day and night. Okay, he is working hard. Okay, and when their online exam was conducting, so he gave his 100%. He did not cheat at all. Okay, and at last he got 95%. Okay, there was another student, he was very smart. He thought that, why to do this paper so honestly? I can cheat and I can score 96%. So he has done cheating and he has scored 96% marks. So on one hand, the student who have burned midnight oil, he was able to score only 95%. And the second student who was just enjoying his life for the whole year, he has done his test by doing cheating. So he has scored 96% marks. So what do you think? He has got success in his life. Only this is the exam that he has scored. After that, after some time, whole of the scenario will definitely change. Now it is changing. Your exams are going to be conducted offline. So the students, those who have not studied for the whole year, those who were so smart, those who were using technologies, Google, etc., to find out the answers and only typing and copying. Now they are in confusion. They are in problem, because now a time has come for all those persons who have burned midnight oil, who have really given their 100%, who were working day and night. Now they are relaxed because all the concepts are clear in their mind. And whether the exam will be conducted online or offline, parents are not worried. Teachers are not worried for them. And the board himself or herself is also not worried at all. Agree or not, Simran?
Yes, ma'am, totally.
So the persons who were doing smart work for 1.5 years, because we have been suffering for last 1.5 years. So those who were conducting their exams smartly, now I think they are in tension. But those who were revising all the formulas, concept, they were listening to the teacher, they were attending each and every lecture, I think they are now more confident and they are less worried. So smart work is there or hard work is there?
Ma'am, definitely, according to me, in my opinion, everyone has different. According to me, both are there. I mentioned this word that sometimes smart work is more appreciable. So I know you're explaining according to the poem, but it was just my query. So I cleared it out. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, sometimes smart work is there. But I think the people who are hardworking, who are laborious, who do their work with, you can say, heart, body, soul, who give 100% to their work, definitely sooner or later, they will get success in their life. Okay, because without doing hard work, yes, nobody can get success.
Instead of doing smart work, you should do hard work smart.
Yes, Yogi is saying instead of doing hard work only, we should do hard work smartly. That is also good. So let's, okay, Aditya, show me your face, then I will be giving you a chance to speak. Yes,
ma'am. Actually, I have joined late the class because I was not reading the schedule. So, ma'am, please can you tell that what is that topic?
This poem we are revising, The Road Not Taken.
Okay.
So this poem is basically about making a choice in life, and this choice can shape our future. Sometimes there are so many alternatives, so many choices are in front of us, and we have to choose appropriate choice. Okay, because one, if we take one of the wrong decision, so this wrong decision can spoil our life. Okay, and we are not able to, you can say, rectify that, because if one of the decision is taken, we are not able to rectify that, and we have to regret afterwards. Okay, so that's why here the poet is putting emphasis that we should take right decision, because right decisions, making correct choices, that is very much crucial part for every individual, because any wrong decision can spoil our life. So I'm going to take one stanza. Okay, so it is basically a deep autumn wood where two roads are diverged into two ways like a fork. So the poet immediately he understands that as a traveler he cannot travel both the sides, so he has to take one of the decision. Either he has to go left side or right side. Okay, but both of the roads are bent in undergrowth. So this undergrowth here represent, what is undergrowth? It can be asked in MCQ also. What is undergrowth here? Can anybody tell me? Bushes? No. What is undergrowth here? Can anybody tell me what is undergrowth? Undergrowth here means unknown world. Unknown world, because the world that they haven't seen, that unknown word is undergrowth. This word is representing them. Okay. Then he looked at the other side. That other side is also appealing to him. Okay. And it seems that the first side is less traveled. Okay. So this stanza suggests that he has to take one decision, either to go one side or to go another side. But he wished to follow the crowd. First of all, he made up his mind that he should follow the crowd. But after that, he changes his mind. So what do you think? One should follow the crowd or one should take independent decision? Suppose there are 46 students in your class. 40 are, you can say, carefree, careless. They are not thinking about their future. They are only living in present that, yes, by hook or crook, they should clear the exam. They are not thinking about the consequences. So 40 crowd is there, and there are 6 who are sitting at side. They are doing their 100%. They are giving their 100%. They are working day and night. So if you have to take one decision, but you have to follow that 40 or you have to follow that 6? No. So many students, what will they do? They will say that these 6 are fool, but these 40 are very smart. So I should be the part of crowd. But there will be others also who will think, no, I should fall into that category of 6 students, those who are burning midnight oil, those who are giving their 100%, those who are really laborious, because they want to be something in their life, that the path which is chosen by those 6 students, that is very difficult. But the path that is chosen by 40 students, that is easy one. So here in second stanza, when the poet has to take decision, first of all, he made up his mind that he should be the part of a crowd. But after that, he changes his mind and he says, no, he doesn't want to follow that path which is traveled by so many people. He chose that path which was less traveled. Okay, so in the morning when he was standing, so he looked in front of him and he says that leaves were covered both of the sides. Okay, and in this morning, nobody has taken any of the path. Okay, because the leaves were undisturbed. It means the choice that has been taken by a poet, that is unknown to him. Okay. But here the poet is committed to his decision. Why he is committed to his decision? Okay, because he says that this path he will take on some other day. It means this line symbolizes, what is the symbol used here? That the choice he make, the other choice in the life, if he is not satisfied with the result. Okay, so in years to come, the poet says he will be telling others about the choice he has made. It means he will talk about the decision that he has taken in his life. Okay, so while making his decision, he will sigh, he will relieve that whatever the decision he has made, whatever the choice he has made, it means he has made a right choice. Okay, or he will regret that he made the wrong choice. So whether right or wrong, the choice will have a significant impact on his life. It means whatever the decision he has taken, whether he has taken right decision, whether he has taken wrong decision, so whatever the choice he has made, that choice will have a very, you can say, very drastic impact on his life. So in this poem, there are so many poetic devices which are being used. So I'm going to discuss all these poetic devices because it can also be asked in your paper. Okay. So very first line, two roads diverged in a yellow wood. So which poetic device is used here? Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. What is the poetic device used here? Because it is personification. Why personification? Because it is used for inanimate object or animals or birds. When animals or birds look or feel like human. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. So roads can be treated that they are just like forks and they have two parts. So this road is taking as a living object. It has been personified. It has been personified. So which poetic device will be there? Personification. So if it is asked in MCQ form also, so you should be very much confident that these roads are being personified. Roads are being personified. Okay. After that, there is a imagery also. Imagery poetic device is also used. Why imagery? See, imagery means to use figurative language. So for this line, another poetic device we can also say that is also imagery. Because when we go through this poem, what visual image comes in front of us? That we are standing at one place and in front of us, two roads are diverged. One is going in that side, another is going in that side. So imagery, that is also right. Okay, so personification there, imagery also, and metaphor. Where metaphor poetic device is used in this point? When we make compare two things. So metaphor. Now tell me one example of metaphor here. Yes, whole of the poem that is making comparison between two things. So there is a metaphor. Why so? Because metaphor is a device that compares two things. That compares two things or two qualities. And these two things, two qualities are unlike. They are not similar at all. See, two roads, they were completely opposite to each other. So here, I have told you about personification, imagery, and matter. Clear? So I have given you the gist of this poem in short. Clear? Now let's do next poem. Let's revise next poem. Next poem we have is Wind. Bachcha, don't talk. So after that, we have another poem that we are going to revise, that is Wind. Okay. So Wind here is symbolizing a destruction. Here, this poem is written by Subramaniam Bharti. Okay. And but this poem was translated from Tamil by A.K. Ramanujan. Okay. So here the poet is making a plead. Poet is making a request. To why? Why it is making a request? Because whenever the wind comes, it causes destruction. Okay. So whenever the wind comes, it breaks the shutters of the windows. It scatters all the papers because the movement of the wind is so fast. Okay. There are so many books which are kept on the shelf that are also thrown down. So here the speaker of the poem, the poet of the poem, it is making a plead, it is making a request. What request it is making? It is making a request that you just don't bring destruction, because whenever you are coming, so you are scattering the paper, you are breaking the shutters of the windows, and you are tearing the pages of the books. And moreover, when you come, you are bringing rain also. So you are very clever. So these are the words which are used for wind. Because for rich people, there is no effect of rain because they are living in their luxurious house. But poor people, okay, so this is causing destruction to them because of the heavy flow of wind. Their houses, their doors, their rafters, all the things, you can say, they are being destructed. Okay, so that's why he is making a request to God, wind God, okay, that you just don't do this thing. And he is making a request that let's build strong homes, let's join the... So here, this poem is also giving us a message. See, when the request will be made to wind, do you think it will change? No. So here the poet is giving a very beautiful message. That so many instructions, so many pleads, so many requests are being made in front of a wind, but wind is not about to change. So here it means obstacles, problems, troubles, hurdles, all the things will come in our mind. Okay. All the things will come in front of us. So where the change is to be made, we have to change ourselves. We have to be firm. We have to be strong. Okay. So here the poet is saying that it will definitely cause destruction. It will bring destruction to poor people. So what is the duty? The duty falls on us. What is that duty? That we should make strong homes. We should join the doors firmly. We should practice to keep our body firm so that we can face all the hurdles and problems. Okay. So when we will be becoming like that, so this rain will become our friend. It will not bring a door of instruction, cause of destruction. It will become our friend. Okay. So the wind will definitely blow weak fire. Okay. But when the fire will be strong and wind will come, so what will be the effect of that? What will be the effect of wind on fire? This fire will roar. It will flourish. It happens. You just imagine. When there is a dim light and heavy wind blows, that dim light will vanish, it will go down. But when there is a strong fire, so it will flourish, it will roar. So we should make friendship with all those hurdles and problems. It means we should be strong enough to face all these problems, because when we will be used to that, when we'll become firm, strong, determined, all the things, qualities we will be having, then these destruction will become our friend. They will make us strong and we will be able to face all these problems in our life. Okay, so this is all about told in this poem. So let's take the poetic device. Which poetic device is used here? Yes, here wind is being animated as a real object. So here it is a personification. Yes, Simran, your doubt?
No, ma'am, not the doubt. I was going to tell the poetic device. Second one is anaphora.
Okay, how is that? Anaphora? Because there is a repetition of some words again and again. Okay, how is that? Don't see in second, third, and fourth line. Don't break the shutters, don't scatter the papers, don't throw down the papers. So don't and don't, three times it has been repeated. So it is anaphora. Bache, such kind of questions can be asked in your MCQ. Don't think that your MCQ paper will be very easy and there is no need to put efforts. Now you have to read between the lines. You have to understand the text in detail. Okay, so anaphora. Now tell me any another example of anaphora.
Crumbling.
Sixth line. You tore the pages of the books. You brought rain again. You are very clever at poking fun at weaklings. You and you word is being repeated. So it is another example of anaphora. So I have given you two examples. Don't. You. Now tell me another example.
Crumbling.
Crumbling. Crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. So crumbling and crumbling is given. And after that, crumbling. Then, and another example, let's build strong homes, let's join the doors firmly. So from these examples, we can say that these are the examples of anaphora. Why so? Because these words are being repeated in a successive lines. See, don't get confused between alliteration and this. Because in your MCQ, it can be there. It is alliteration example. Suppose don't, these examples are given. So you can get confused between it is alliteration or it is anaphora is a repetition in successive lines. That is a repetition of sound and consonant alliteration. It can be in same line also. But here successive lines are given. When we have been given, very good. I'm telling you useless thing, na? That's why you have started conversing. So anaphora, that is that lines are being repeated in successive lines. So that is the example of anaphora. Now bell has gone. We will revise some other topics tomorrow. So get ready with your listening task today.